Okay. Hello everybody, 早上好。今天呢，我就是单枪匹马 ，I'm gonna be a solo on a solo ride today. So this morning, okay, welcome back to the Silver Click at Radin Mas. 我是 Chef Eric. So I've been with y'all for quite a number of episodes. Today is the last one for this series, but nonetheless, we'll still be continuing with another new series back in September as well. So for this episode, what are we going to show you? We're going to show you two very interesting recipes. 两道很简单又是非常有特别的小吃，是有点台湾风味，也是可以说有点上海风味。So it's both Taiwanese and Shanghainese inspired. We have a hot and sour soup that we're going to make with some special ingredients. I will explain more details along the way. And then we're also going to make a salt and pepper crispy chicken, okay, which is very popular. 你可以做成椒盐鸡，或者是做成just a normal popcorn chicken, okay, with some seasonings on top. It's all possible. So what we're going to start off with first is for today's session, we'll start off with marinating the chicken first. Okay, so for chicken, let's have a look at our ingredients. Okay, so for chicken, we've got some boneless chicken leg meat here. 这个是切成鸡丁的这个鸡肉。Okay, so 我们就用这个鸡腿肉把它切成鸡丁。So we cut it up into dices. We'll put this in our mixing bowl first. And from here, we're going to add a little bit of seasoning. So we got some salt. Okay, we just add a pinch of salt to it. A little bit of garlic powder. Okay, or you can use minced garlic, the dried ones. Yeah.干的那个蒜蓉粉都可以。Okay. So we have the garlic powder added in. And then a little bit of pepper, 少许的胡椒粉。And then a splash of sesame oil, some sesame oil to go in. Then we mix everything up first.Okay, so we can coat this thing up with some starch before we fry it off. And if let's say you happen to have some extra egg or egg white or beaten egg around, you can add a bit of egg to this mixture so that it can catch the flour better. But if you don't have the egg, you can just simply, you know, dust it up straight away. It still works also. Okay, so如果你家里有剩下的这个蛋白的话呢，你做饼干剩下的蛋白，你可以加少许的蛋白下去。这个蛋白的作用呢，就是你加了一点蛋白下去呢，等一下你沾那个生粉的时候呢，它会沾的比较多，你炸出来的话就会比较脆一点的。不过如果没有这个蛋浆或者是这个蛋白的话呢，直接炸在那个生粉上面也是可以的。Okay, so 这个生粉呢，你可以用我们俗称的这个土豆粉，或者是这个风车粉啊，对，就是我们的这个生粉啊。如果你要用地瓜粉的话也是可以的。 Okay, you can use sweet potato starch. Alright. Okay, so from here we marinate everything, the chicken, we put it aside. Then if you want, you can dust it up first. Okay, coat it up with the starch, let it sit for a while. Okay, 就是讲在炸之前呢，我们先把它沾成那个粉之后呢放在一边，可以给它停留一下。OK, 等一下我们才炸，先把它给沾上那个粉好了。OK, 沾均匀一点。OK, 我们把它给沾均匀一点，所以 catch all the bit of starch all over.Okay, then we just put the rest in. Okay, put it aside. Continue to... So we'll leave it to rest for a while. Okay, and while the chicken is resting before we fry it off, I'll explain to everyone what we can do, what the ingredients that will be required for the second recipe. Okay, so feel free to share your questions in if you have, since we are doing this as a pre-recorded episode.So we will still be here to support your questions. If you have anything that you want to clarify, just let us know. OK? Okay, so we put our starch aside. Chicken already prepared. We leave it as it is. So this is our first dish for today. Okay, our marinated chicken dusted up with some potato starch. Okay, you can use sweet potato starch. You can use regular potato starch if you want. And then we're gonna later on after cooking, we're gonna make a simple seasoning over it. Okay, with a bit of five spice and the sour plum powder on it as well. Okay, so we put this aside. Then what we're gonna do is that we're gonna introduce to you the ingredients for the hot and sour soup. Okay, 我们接下来为你们介绍一下这个酸辣汤的这个材料。 Okay, 酸辣汤的材料呢，今天的酸辣汤呢是有点特别，因为我们煮的这个酸辣汤呢是带有一些特别的材料。那基本上呢，我们还是有我们的这个豆腐啊、鱼啊、这个鱼苗啊、这个香菇呢，我们用这个日本。 这个小鲜菇 Honshu Meiji Mushroom 来代替，啊，所以你就可以变通一下。这个是冬笋 ，OK， 切丝的这个冬笋，我们把它切丝。这个是木耳，已经泡过水，把它切断，切成丝也是。那么基本上这个酸辣汤的这个味道呢 ，OK， the hot and sour soup， will be flavored up by this very common chili paste that we know. This is 这个是老干妈的辣椒酱。 那个辣椒，对，所以现在我们到处在外面吃这个火锅啊 ，when we have our steamboat, our mala steamboat, this 老干妈 is one of the important condiments that they will serve on the side as well. So this is also a very good chili paste. Okay, you walk into any supermarket, they'll be selling it now because it's a very popular cooking ingredient. And then we'll add this to the soup itself. So just to run through the ingredients again once more, we have tofu. Honshu Meiji mushrooms instead of shiitake today. We've got our winter bamboo shoots also all sliced up. This is black fungus already pre-soaked and sliced up at the same time. So for ingredient substitution, fish maw, you can replace this with pig tendons or pig skin, the puff up pork skin, it can be done. Okay, so if you want to change or you want to change it to sea cucumber, you can also add sea cucumber in to the soup itself. So it's quite flexible. We have a little bit of seafood, we have a little bit of other ingredients as well. And the unique thing that we're going to add in, topping it up, is the century egg. Okay, 这个是我们的皮蛋，这个皮蛋呢，就是我们今天的特别材料。因为很多人没有想象到，喝酸辣汤加皮蛋，这个概念，为什么呢？因为皮蛋其实跟酸辣汤是很搭配的。你们在有去过台湾或者中国旅行的话，有吃到酸辣汤的话，有喝到酸辣汤的话。 他们那边有放一点皮蛋下去，yeah, it's an acquired taste. Not everybody likes century eggs, 是不是每个人都会喜欢皮蛋的味道？可是我本身呢，就是很喜欢这个皮蛋的那个口感。So 如果你不吃皮蛋的话呢，就不要下这个皮蛋。我们还是需要一点蛋，就把它打散，做成一个蛋花。Okay, so you still add a little bit of beaten egg. Even if you don't take century egg, you still need the beaten egg to create the egg drop effect. Okay, a little bit of Chinese celery towards the end, we'll add it in together with the century egg. And then these are our basic seasoning ingredients. We're going to start off the soup with some diced garlic. Okay, we'll start it off. And then this is our soy sauce, our black vinegar, okay, chili oil, and this is pepper powder, and the chicken seasoning powder, or you can use the concentrated chicken seasoning stock also can. Yeah, so for a hot and sour soup, if you like it extra spicy, it's no point to add so much of the laogama chili paste because it's not so hot, as well as the chili oil. If you are someone that wants to go for a super spicy kick, dice up some red chili powder and throw it in during your cooking process. Yeah, then that will increase the intensity of the chili's spiciness. Okay, so with this basic chili oil and the laogama chili paste, it's considered a very mid-range or mild kind of a hot and sour soup. Yeah, so we're not going to make it so intense that, you know, not everybody in the family can appreciate it. So we make it a little bit more moderate, but if you like to have extra kick of spiciness, you just chop some fresh chili powder in. So how are we going to do our soup? Basically, okay, we're going to start off by preparing the soup base first, which is to fry up some garlic, and then we're going to add some water in to start off our stock, and then I will adjust with our seasonings. So let me get some water on standby. Okay, so in our soup pot, we add a little bit of oil. Fry up our garlic first. Okay, so we get some garlic going. 先把这个蒜蓉呢给爆香先，爆香了之后呢，我们就加我们的其他的材料，就是我们的冬笋啊，这个木耳啊、香菇啊，我们就把水倒下去，做成了我们的这个汤底。OK， 所以我们先现在锅里面下了油，放了蒜蓉，给它煮爆香先。All right, so this hot and sour soup, usually we just drink it as it is. We take it as it is. We just enjoy it as it is. But actually, for hot and sour soup, I have a little personal favorite way of appreciating it, which I want to share with you all. Okay, 就是讲我每次喝这个酸辣汤啊，我旁边啊一定要有油条的。 I always have the yuzhakui next to me when I take the hot and sour soup because it's such a nice thing to dip the yuzhakui with. Okay, so 你如果没有试过的话呢，你可以 try 一下，去买油条，现成的油条，把它配搭在这个酸辣汤。 非常好吃的，非常一个适合的搭配。OK，你们可以不妨考虑一下，如果你要煮酸辣汤，当天呢去买点油条，那么要吃的时候呢，把这个油条放在烤箱弄热一下，那么再配搭这个酸辣汤，就好像你吃粥跟油条一样的道理。OK， 所以这个蒜蓉呢爆香了之后呢，我们就下我们的这个笋，还有这个木耳。 少许的笋跟木耳，我们先放下去炒炒一下。OK， 我们这个先把这个笋跟木耳爆香。那么爆香了之后呢，我们就可以加我们的其他的材料。这边我先热一个锅，等一下准备炸我们的这个鸡肉。OK， 这个就是我们的 Honshi Meiji Mushroom， 我们用这个来代替那个香菇，对。 所以这些材料呢，你们都可以变通的。如果你没有那个新鲜的，没有那个家里没有香菇的话，你可以买新鲜的这个这些菇菌的这些菇菌的类似的东西呢，来代替。黑木耳呢，你可以换成白木耳都可以的。所以这个材料可以变通一下。如果你不能吃笋的话呢，要放其他材料可以，你可以放点丝瓜。 或者切这个毛瓜切丝放下去都可以。OK， 所以我们就把这些材料炒炒一下，炒了之后呢，我们就要加我们的这个老干妈辣椒下去。OK， 老干妈辣椒你加下去呢，它就会给那个汤它的需要的那个颜色。OK， 还有这个是辣椒油，少许的这个辣椒油。OK， 我们就跟它炒炒一下。 炒了之后呢，我们就放我们的水，OK， 少许的水放下去。OK， 我这边是煮差不多大概一人的两个人的分量了，比较少一点，对。OK， 水放下去之后呢，OK， 我们就开大火给它滚上来。那么在等它滚的时候呢，我们可以做一点基本的调味料，就是把我们的 这个鸡精粉呢放下去，可以少许的这个鸡精粉，这个是酱青，酱青也是会给它一点颜色，可以差不多一汤匙的酱青。那么胡椒粉，可以胡椒粉你就可以放多一点，这个白或者黑的胡椒粉就可以放多一点，给它带有一个比较呛的辣味。 OK， 其他的材料呢？我们的这个鱼鳔呢，也是可以放下去，豆腐呢也是可以放一点，OK， 煮煮一下。那么这个辣味已经有了，咸味也是有了，我们只是还没有放这个酸的味道下去。酸的味道呢，我们就是用 这个镇江黑醋或者浙醋都可以，可是醋呢，如果你放在高温的汤水里面呢， 它的酸味会被蒸发掉，所以我们就是先把这个醋呢留在这个尾后，我们才把这个醋加进去。OK，我们先把这些材料全部给煮一下，煮上了之后呢，我们试一下我们的调味，那么最后才勾一个芡，才把这个蛋呢还有这个醋呢给放下去。 大致上应该是 OK 了，留下多一点胡椒粉，后面才留点给那个鸡丁。OK， 我们这边呢热锅呢先放点油下去准备炸我们的鸡丁啊，看慢慢的热上来。这边呢我们的这个酸辣汤，你看那个颜色很漂亮。 可以跟你们外面吃的那个颜色，酸辣汤的颜色差不多，几乎都是一样。可以给它煮上来先。这是刚才我们蒸的生粉的这个鸡肉，所以先把那个油给烧开，大概差不多有170度左右，我们才放这个鸡肉下去炸。可以说汤在煮，那么等一下最后呢，我们勾完芡之后呢，我们才放。 这个放了我们的这个皮蛋，还有这个蛋花下去。OK，这个是勾芡的用的那个太白粉，我们等一下准备勾芡一下。 OK， 接下来我们。 接下来要准备一点这个调味粉。OK， 我们看一下我们的酸辣汤，味道，它的汤慢慢的煮上来。OK， 全部的材料都下了。 有那个底味，它一滚上来呢，我们就可以先勾一点芡。OK， 在这边呢也是要跟大家讲一个好消息，就是从9月开始呢，我们的这个烹饪现播的这个烹饪节目呢会开放给观众们来到现场。 一起我们看我们的这个烹煮 ，so we are opening up the sessions to a limited audience. Okay, from September onwards. So if you like to attend the sessions in person, please get in touch with the CC itself. Once we have limited seats available, so when you register yourself and we inform you or we have sent you the confirmation, basically. You can attend in person for the cooking sessions that we have every Saturday morning. And of course, you also get a chance to sample all the delicious recipes that we are putting out. Okay, so 你们可以到现场来跟我们一起参加这个现场的这个烹饪节目。那么当然呢，节目做完之后呢，你们也是可以试吃我们在这里烹调的那些不同的那些佳肴。那么这边呢，我们的油差不多也是烧热了，我们的这个酸辣汤也是。 开始滚上来呢，我们就要准备勾芡。OK， 我们先把这个太白粉 ，OK， 掺在水里面，那么接下去拿去勾芡。OK， 不要弄得太稠了，大概有点像鱼翅的那个程度就可以了。 OK， 我们看一下，再 check 一下它的味道，可以稍微的附加一点这个鸡精粉。OK， 勾完芡之后呢， 我们的这个蛋呢可以打散，可以把这个蛋给先打散，轻轻的打散呢加下去。OK， 把这个蛋浆加下去，只它煮上来就有那个蛋花的那个表面。OK， 给它煮一下。OK， 好了之后呢，最后呢，我们先把火给关掉，再加我们的这个醋。那么你爱吃多酸呢，那个醋呢，你就跟着一起调味的放下去。OK， 大致上就 OK 了。我们的酸辣汤一下就可以盛上来。这个油烧开了，热了之后呢，我们就要把我们的鸡肉放下去炸。OK， 我们就先放下去一块的，慢慢每一块慢慢炸上来。OK，so we fry our chicken when the oil is moderately hot. Till we get a nice crispy golden brown texture. Okay, the cooking time about 4 to 5 minutes, roughly. Okay, use a small pot of oil to fry. We do it in batches so that you don't waste too much oil. Okay, and our fire is only so big, so we can only do it in batches. Don't fry everything at one go, otherwise, you'll find that, you know, your fire is not big enough to support the temperature of the oil, and the food gets soggy. So we just fry them in batches until they are nice and golden brown. It's our hot and sour soup, so we'll retain our garnishes. Then let me just move this away. Okay, so remember, okay, from next session, the September sessions onward, we welcome a live audience, but we have limited seatings. So you can book your seats early and get to enjoy some of the recipes that we're going to share with you here. So while the chicken is frying off, we make our seasoning. We need to have a little bit of salt. Okay, a little bit of salt here. Some five spice powder, and this is our salted plum 酸梅粉啊。如果你喜欢吃辣的话呢，你也是可以加一点辣椒粉下去。OK， 啊，基本上呢，我们就是把这个给拌均匀先。你要放在这个锅里面炒炒一下也是可以，可是我们这样，在锅里面这样，这个碗里面这样拌就可以了。So we just need to mix it all up. We'll use this to sprinkle on the chicken later on. Okay, 把它给拌均匀。鸡肉差不多了，炸到差不多金黄色为止，有点稍微的金黄色。可以这样，可以拿出来的。Okay, so we just put it in. So we're going to toss this up in our plate. Yeah, toss up with the spice mix that we just prepared. And then we'll add it on right to the plate after that with some garnishes. So we just fry up the chicken first. Another batch that we can cook. Okay, the remaining chicken, we'll fry it off. OK， 刚才我们做的这个调味粉呢，我们就撒一点在上面 ，sprinkle some on it。搅拌均匀。OK， 我们再拌在我们的这个盘子上面。它有那个五香粉跟那个酸梅粉的那个香味，再附加一点，这个是剁碎的辣椒，可以作为我们的点缀，少许的青葱，再加一点芝麻。OK， 这个就是我们的第一道，我们的这个香酥椒盐这个鸡丁啊，这边还有多一点这个鸡肉在炸。就大概差不多要熟的时候，我们就把它捞上来。So we'll bring it up when it's golden brown. So now it's still a little bit of frying more to go. At the same time, okay, we can garnish our soup. 我们的汤煮好了。Okay, 这个是煮好的酸辣汤。我们呈现那个料，不同的料。OK， 等一下啊，先把这个鸡肉拿上来，这个鸡肉熟了，先把它拿上来。调味粉少许，给葱，点芝麻，这个我们就放在一边，等一下后背那个背后的荧幕背后的那些人士就可以，工作人士就可以试试看。OK， 我们这边好了，我们就要加我们的这个酸辣汤的材料，附加一些材料，这个就是我们的皮蛋，直接放在上面，等一下吃的时候呢，搅搅一下就可以了。少许的这个芹菜，对。那么如果你有买到的油条的话呢，你就可以直接这样配搭油条这样吃，就一个非常开胃的一个酸辣汤跟配搭这个油条呢，是非常好吃的一个搭配。所以我们今天这两道菜呢，就是有这个酸辣汤，还有这个盐酥鸡。Okay, so it's a crispy chicken with a hot and sour soup with a special century egg topping as well as Chinese celery. Make sure you can add other ingredients if you want. If you don't take century egg, you can omit it totally.It'll be nice to serve this with a crispy youtiao on the side, as a to dip it in with, okay, as a good way to appreciate it. So, thank you for spending your time to watch today's session. Please feel free to ask any questions, although we have pre-recorded it. And remember, from September onwards, okay, we will be inviting you all to come in as a live audience for the sessions here, but.With the limited seatings, please register with the CC early and they will confirm your attendance. And then you get to come here to watch, to enjoy, and to interact with us as well. So have a good weekend, okay? Enjoy the rest of the weekend. And then we will see you in our new series of sessions coming in September. All right, thank you for your time. 谢谢你们大家收看的时间。我们在九月的时候呢，再跟你们一起见面。Bye bye.
OK，你们先不要走啊，因为不要先走，不要先走
没有，我没有跟你打。
OK Chef Eric 你在吗？Chef Eric，
没有放，没有，你没有热气的话，不需要打进去的。啊，如果
OK，跟你们
热
等多一
气你
下
没打，
子，
你没有热气你就不需要。
他刚才讲会来做解答问
啊，
题，the chef will be here
烹饪就是
later
烹饪，
in a
烹饪
while
档，
to
如
do
果别的地
some
方有
Q&A。
合适的话，你可以跟我
In the
说，如果
meantime,
啊，
I
可以
will
打的话，你可以
screen
打。
share the QR code for you guys to scan.你们等多一下子啊，那个厨师应该是要来了。
那 QR code 是用什么作用的？
OK，这个 QR code 你们 scan 会拿到那个 passion 卡的分数。
我怎么样去 scan 呢？这样子。
你需要用你电话了那个 QR 码的 scanner，或者如果你是用 Android 的话，用那个 Google Lens。
但是我现在我在手机看嘛，我怎么样去问
你可以
那个？
先 screenshot 那个 QR 码。
但是我不懂得怎么进去，scan 呢？
你用那个 Google Lens 或者用那个 QR code scanner 的时候，他们可以 scan 从你的 phone gallery。
但是我要出去是吗？但是出去可以 scan 得到吗？我scan。
不用出去，你可以先screenshot 拍那个 QR code。
首先拍那个 QR code 了，这用手机来拍那个 QR code 了。
对。
我拍了 QR code，然后怎么样 scan 呢？
你拍了那个 QR code 之后呢，当你出来过后，你就用那个 QR code scanner，或者你用 Google Lens。
Google Lens 也我要当个 Google Lens，对不对
对。
呀？那个 Google Lens 怎么样 scan 啊？
OK Google
Google
LE
Space，
Space。
然后呢，Space how to spell？L
LENS
E
NS
NES 啊
LENS
，LEN
S
S 没有 E 啊，LENS 啊，我要当做这一个，对不对？
对。
哦，就这当做这个我，然后就我在我的手机那边拍了这个，就是进去。对的，那个 Google Lens 以后都可以用的，当得了，对吗？
对，可以用这个来拍QR 码。
Good morning, everybody.
OK，Chef Eric 在了。
大家早上好。sorry 啊，今天有点有地方有其他的 program，so 我们做了一个 pre-record。说你们刚才看的那个video 之后有什么问题要问的我现在在电视上可以跟你们先解答。So I can try answer your questions here since we did a pre-recorded。So just feel free to ask。
请问那个酸辣汤哦，我们是不是可以放那个紫菜？
可以，其实酸辣汤它是一个汤底来的，那个馅料的话，你们可以自己自动变化，只要它不要改到那个汤的味道太呛的话， 就可以的，可以很多东西很多材料你可以自己变化放下去的，只要它的味道是没有想到那个汤味就可以，所以紫菜也是没有 OK 是 OK 的。
Yeah, so there's another question in the chat. What natural ingredients can be used instead of MSG?
Okay, natural instead of the chicken stock powder. Okay, 其实很多这些调味料啊，大致上他们是无添加纯的味精，可是很多材料方面都已经有那个是天然的味精在他们的成分。So actually, this one, let me just explain to everybody since we are all still here on the page, right? 这个是关于味精 的问题。味精呢，对我们大家来讲呢，是一个有点所谓的有点比较敏感的一个话题啦。因为每个人都觉得说味精，是一个不好的那个所谓的添加，调味料。其实什么是叫味精？你们真正的有懂去了解吗？我借这个机会跟大家分享一下 ，Let me just share with you all what actually is MSG, because I think this is very sensitive to a lot of people, in the sense that it has always been portrayed in a very bad image. So, as a professional chef, having worked in food science industries before, MSG is actually a natural occurring thing. That's the glutamates are is actually naturally occurring in a lot of the natural foods that we eat.我们每天吃的这些番茄、香菇、海鲜类、肉类啊，它们自然 天分里面呢、啊，都已经有那个那个味精的那个精华，不是那个盐，不是它那个精华已经在那边的。所以，味精的这个东西啊，其实也是个天然酿出来的一个调味料。So, what is really MSG? MSG is actually a salt plus a glutamate element and component.That's naturally derived. 基本上味精是用什么材料做呢 ？What is the ingredients that we use to make MSG powder? It's basically sugar cane, corn, rice, rice, as well as certain types of hydrolyzed proteins. So, in from a food science angle aspect, the ingredients are also natural. Okay, even sago starch is also sometimes used in the production of MSG, and it's not.Any kind of a chemical formulation where we just put a couple of chemicals together to produce MSG. No, it's actually produced from fermentation and hydrolysis processes. And when you talk about fermentation, 就是发酵的这个做法呢，我们很多亚洲风味的一些材料跟调味料呢，都是需要发酵来导致它有这个。所谓的调味的技能，说你想一想，我们每天吃的豆瓣酱啊、味噌啊、酱油啊、酱青这些，都是发酵过的调味料，这些都有天然的味精已经存在他们的料理的那个调味料里面，说这些所谓的我们在厨房用的调味料啊，很多厨房。你们在外面吃饭的时候，你们很多厨房会跟你讲，哦，我们的厨房不用味精，对，他们是不用那个天然那个味精粉酿出来的味精粉，可是他们里面那些调味料，鱼露啊、蚝油啊、酱油、酱青啊、豆瓣酱啊、豆酱这些，都已经有存在天然的味精或者是味精的成分，所以我们吃了味精啊，少许的部分啊，吃了少许的味精啊。我们用在调味料的时候呢，用少许的味精的话呢，其实是对我们的那个健康是有帮助的，因为味精里面有少许的盐分。我们现在每个人都很怕吃咸的东西，可是我们需要盐，盐跟糖，对我们的身体是有益的，只是不要吃的太多，也不要吃的太少。每个人都讲我们吃太多，可是没有人想到我们吃太少的话，对我们的身体健康也是有问题。因为盐跟血，盐跟糖是，会影响到我们的，那个血压循环。所以这种东西呢，就是每一样东西呢，不一样，这些东西呢，就是大致上需要我们还是需要吃，可是不要吃的太多，也不要吃的太少。就是跟盐、跟糖、跟油、脂肪全部都是一样的。 那么for MSG 啊，我觉得他说啊，这个世界上的那个饮食那个食品产品跟那些饮食业呢，是不能完全去掉的，因为这个天然味精跟这个所谓的味精粉呢，是在帮忙很多家庭主妇跟餐饮的厨师呢做这个很好的调味。那么问题是因为味精就是所谓的它能提鲜的功能，它不是一个所谓的代替材料的功能，所以以前呢就是有过这个问题，就是很多厨师呢不会充分的利用味精，就是把它放得太多，放得太多的话呢，它的盐的成分就变成很高，就变成味道食物的味道呢可能很太过浓太过呛，甚至于也会有太多的盐 的成分， too much salt in the thing, because monosodium glutamate or MSG is actually a salt also, and for MSG to work,它还是要跟一个跟盐一起搭配才能促销它才能发挥它的功能。那么for MSG 呢，这个就是这个味精呢，你们如果有这样试过它的那个味精粉呢，它的味道其实是不咸的，它是个半咸甜的综合。Okay, it's not MSG is not salty at all in terms of taste. It will never be as salty as salt. And that's the reason why it's an enhancer. It's not an ingredient or flavor replacer. It is an enhancement ingredient. So 我们在以前的料理，我们就放味噌啊、香菇啊、我们的卤水里面，我们酱油、酱青这些，就是要提鲜，提升那个提鲜的味道呢，变成我们吃东西有那个口味、口诀、口感。就是吃的会比较好，觉得这个东西比较好吃一点。那么全世界上的人呢，全世界上的不同的国家吃味精的国家是最大是哪里，最多是哪里，其实不是中国，是日本。可是日本人你看他们吃了味精之后，他们有什么问题吗？没有。因为为什么呢？日本人他们是全世界最厉害采用味精来做调味 的厨师们，因为他们那边就是这样有这种知识，他们有这种研发味精好的味精的这种知识。其实外面买的味精啊，有好跟坏的味精，就是讲说产品的等级啊。There's good and bad quality MSG. The good quality MSG, there's less salt, more glutamate, so that it enhances the food that we cook. Whereas the what we call the cheap MSG, they cannot afford to put so much glutamate because making the glutamate is expensive.So they add more salt to bulk up the weight so that they can sell it cheaper. That's the reason why the lower grade of MSG does taste a little bit more salty than the good grade ones. You can talk to a few different restaurant chefs, especially Chinese restaurant chefs. They will tell you that they only use the best quality MSG, which is quite expensive because the price is almost 10 times the price of a regular MSG that we buy. And those kind of MSG powder do notHave much less salt, and they do not affect the saltiness of the food. The saltiness of it still, the savoriness or saltiness of it still comes from either salt or soy sauce or oyster sauce as a secondary ingredient. Okay, so just let me go through the chat bar. Let me just take the questions first. There's a few questions here. Okay, Y-Fong, 有你的问题是可以加入金针代替笋，可以，没有问题。如果你不能吃笋，因为你在有吃中药，他们讲有时不可以吃笋的话，可以用金针菇来代替，没有问题的。Yeah. OK. All right. 谢谢你们。OK. Cheryl, your question. The processing of natural MSG, there's no other synthetic chemicals. No. There's no. If you ever have a chance to visit Ajinomoto's factory on the educational tour, please go and see for yourself. Yes, because.It's as I mentioned before, the four main ingredients for making MSG is actually tapioca, sago, sugar cane, and corn. Okay, just these four ingredients, 这个四个材料啊，甘蔗、西米，这个so tapioca 就是我们讲的大薯啊，那个秋枝啊，对，还有这个两个 starch 啊，对，还有就是 sago tapioca 跟 corn 还有 sugar cane 这四样材料呢，他们去经过发酵跟酿制之后呢， 就会加工了之后呢，就会保就会造成这个天然的这个味精粉。那么味精粉也是可以从海鲜干的海鲜取出，就好像我们的昆布啊、紫菜啊、那个墨鱼啊、干贝啊，这些都有天然的味精在里面的啊，所以它也是可以从那边取出。可是因为这些材料都是很贵呀，所以就是有这种所谓的价钱的问题了。So for your questions, there's no synthetic chemicals added. It's a basically a fermentation and hydrolysis process. Yeah.So you don't have to worry about that. In fact, to produce MSG, right, we need to go through fermentation and hydrolysis. It's not a chemical, what we call mixology or mixing up of certain chemicals to produce it. Yeah. And yeah, 你们稍微可能如果有读一些所谓的我们讲的proper media and channels 啊，你们会观察到啊。全世界的政府还有那些所谓的有名义的那些食品研究所，他们都没有拒绝味精是一个不好的材料。其实美国政府跟新加坡政府都有承认说味精用在少许的食品业里面是 OK 的。对，所以我们本身每天也是需要吃一点盐跟糖来综合调和我们的这个血压循环呢，所以不是说一定要吃的很多，也是说也不要说完全不吃，因为这个是对我们的身体也是有益处的。Okay, May your question on oyster sauce. Okay, 坦白跟你们讲，Let me just share you what's really oyster sauce. Oyster sauce contains anywhere between 0.5% to 1% oyster extract. That is what we call an oyster sauce. The rest of the oyster sauce is actually soy sauce, water, sugar, caramel. Okay, salt. Okay, and of course, certain brands will have added MSG inside as well. And this is basically what we call an oyster sauce. And the same thing like chicken powder also. Okay, everybody thinks that a chicken powder factory 啊，里面应该是一个很大锅的那些老母鸡在那边煮啊， yeah, whole big barrel soup stock pot of boiling fowl in the stock pot, and then after that they condense the stock into a powder form, into a liquid concentrate. Actually, you'll be surprised that inside a factory that produces chicken seasoning powder, there's not even a single chicken feather inside there. Yeah. So how do the raw materials come about? Let me just share with you. Okay. Basically, where does all the boiling fowl goes to after they have finished laying their eggs. 然后母鸡呢，一旦不能再生蛋之后呢，他们就是全部转入这些工厂，宰杀了之后，他们取出来的那些肉呢，全部都会去加工，把它做成天然的鸡肉粉。Okay, so if the boiling fowl is actually slaughtered, processed, the meat is extracted out and dehydrated into a powder, and then from there.Okay, formulation chefs in the factories will take the chicken powder, the chicken fat, okay, together with salt, sugar, MSG. We will formulate out the chicken essence cube, the powder, or the concentrated seasoning stock. So it is still natural ingredients. Yeah. So what we always advise is use sufficiently to enhance the taste of the foods that you cook. Do not use it as a flavor replacer. So in 你们煮一个煮一锅很好的鸡汤，你不放调味料，你不放味精，你不放盐 ，OK， 或者你不放这个鸡精粉的话，你那锅汤你放了多少老母鸡下去熬，也是没有味道的，因为它需要盐跟味精来带出它的鲜味。那么这个就是我们的舌头的适应，所以我们煮菜啊，你们外面讲为什么？在外面吃的东西比较好吃，比家里的东西煮的比较好吃。其实我们在家里也是可以做得到，只是因为我们不敢下太多调味，因为我们看了太多媒体的报道，我们自己吓自己嘛。哎呀，多少才是适量呢？我们自己都不了解，说还是不要放更好。So that's the thing that's holding us all of us back, because we read too much negative reports about MSG and all the food seasoning ingredients for
foods. So we hold ourselves back when we cook. And then as a result, our food becomes bland, tasteless. And then we always find that, hey, the food outside tastes a lot better because, you know, it's more tasty, it's more savory, it's nicer. That's because it's all plays around with the level of seasoning that's used. Yeah, so this is what sometimes that differentiates between home cooks and professional chefs, because we are doing it every day. We know what is the suitable amount. But I also have to tell you all that some places you go when you feel that, 哇，吃饱了之后啊，口很干，很渴。 是不是味精在作用? Is it because of MSG that we feel thirsty? Actually, no. The culprit is not MSG. I don't know why they blame MSG. The real culprit behind it is salt. And the salt is hiding in a lot of other seasonings also, from fish sauce to your soy sauce, to your oyster sauce, to your chicken seasoning powder, to your all your added salt, pure added salt. That is the thing that will make you thirsty. It's not MSG. 因为你们 在厨房的话，如果你去拿点味精粉放在你的舌头啊，你吞下去啊，你不觉得口渴的。如果你用同样的分量去放，同样的分量，如果你是用盐的话，你肯定啊吞得下去啊，你就要找一杯水来喝。这个就是盐的效果，不是味精的效果。所以你们要了解，其实哦，吃东西，你们在外面吃饭吃东西的时候，如果吃饱了之后，你觉得口很渴的话。 是咸的问题，不是味精的问题，所以就是这个就是盐的问题。那个厨师不会充分的利用那个盐，已经下了太多盐，太多这些调味料加进去里面。所以你们看我的视频上教烹饪的时候呢，我用的调味料是很少的，我不会我的食谱的调味料不是很复杂，一个食谱里面就是很纯的，就是基本的。 调味粉或者多一个调味料，最多是两三个咸的调味料，所以不是鱼露呢，就是姜精，不然就是蚝油，不然就是鸡精粉。我不会掺杂很多这些调味料在一起，因为你全部掺到完的话呢，太过咸了。 Too salty if you have too much seasoning ingredients. You follow my recipes on silver clicks here in the Zoom videos, right? You will notice that I use very little types of seasonings. It's always a very simple chicken seasoning powder, or maybe a soy sauce or oyster sauce, or perhaps just a fish sauce. It's good enough. 所以记得你们在家里做菜的时候，不要掺太多调味料，因为每个调味料都有盐，都会有咸味。如果你们掺到太复杂的话，你的食物煮出来就是很咸。所以这个东西你们就是要需要了解。 OK， 歪风，你多一个问题，味精有人说是用鸡骨磨成的，对，其实这个不是错的一个说法，因为骨头里面，无论是甚至人的骨头跟我们人奶啊，都有天然的味精的成分。为什么我们刚刚那些婴儿为什么他们很喜欢？ 喝母奶，因为母奶的那个天然味精的成分是最高的。我们一生出来哈，我们的舌头的味觉啊还没有发育，可是我们已经有那个味觉，来适应味精跟咸味，所以我们一旦出世的时候，我们喝母奶的时候，我们就是第一次体验到味精的那个作能，而且母奶的味精还比牛奶的味精天然成分更高。 那么说到骨头的话呢，为什么我们做汤，我们都要用骨头来熬呢？因为骨头好像那个猪骨啊，还是鸡的骨头呢，它们也是有天然的那个味精的精华的成分，所以我们在那个熬的过程之中呢，熬了几个钟头的过程呢，我们把那个精华给取出来，那么我们就得需要加一点盐下去，才会把那个汤的那个味道呢。 给提出来，所以这个就是为什么我们用要需要用骨头来熬汤，就是有这个道理啊。我们把这个骨头下去熬了几个钟头之后，配搭一些香料啊，这锅汤煮出来之后呢，放少许的盐跟糖作为调味啊，那锅汤就很香很好喝了，就是这个道理。所以你们记得哦，你们在家里熬汤的时候还是需要放盐的，如果你不放盐的话，你的汤是那个味道是取不出来的啊，所以这个
大家可以在自己的厨房适应一下了，慢慢的做你们的这个调味技巧。一个好的厨师啊，就是重点就是在他的调味的技巧的能力。所以这个是我今天要跟大家分享的，因为现在我们今天看 video 比较容易啊，比较有多时间聊一下啊，所以可以跟你们分享一下为什么我们需要用少许的味精在我们的调味在做菜的时候需要用少许的味精来做调味。其实你们只是要了解，一旦你用到了蚝油，你就不需要再放味精，因为蚝油里面也是有天然的味精啊。所以你们在做调味的时候，记得每个调味料都是会有自己的天然味精的，所以你们不需要再附加这个味精。除了一样东西，我在家里煮啊，我会下一些味精粉啊，就是在家里煮什么哪一道菜呢？就是煮咖喱呀。Yeah.咖喱鸡也好，咖喱鱼也好，我都会放少许的味精粉，因为呢，咖喱的食谱里面的材料呢，除了盐之外，没有其他的调味料，没有其他的鱼露啊，那个蚝油还是酱油，所以没有那个天然味精 的存在。那么你煮了一大锅的咖喱呢，如果你要那个香料的味道更香更浓的话呢，你放少许的味精，差不多大概半到一茶匙的味精下去，你整锅咖喱煮出来呢会觉得特别的香，特别的好吃，啊，对，就是，通常鸡骨要熬多久？大致上 ，OK， 这个楚奇，你的问题，大致上我们熬鸡蛋啊，基本上就是少要两个钟到四个钟，或者甚至到六个钟头。那么你在熬的时候，要控制火候。因为你的火太猛的话，那个汤熬出来呢就会 有那种奶白的色，对，所以它就不会清不会那个汤就不会有那个清的看起来就不会很清了，就看起来比较那种 奶白色，因为那个火候太强了。所以我们在熬汤的时候呢，最好是火候呢控制到最低 的慢熬啊，慢熬是最好。如果你要好像那种日本拉面那种汤的那种稠度的话，你就用那个 猛火来滚到它把那个 胶原蛋白全部都给取出来，除了那个骨头的味道之外。OK， 所以鸡骨也好，肉骨也好，都是同样的道理。那么最好呢，我们在熬汤的时候呢，骨头呢全部给沸过水一下，沸过一次的热水，开水把它弄干净，去掉那个血液，那么你们才开始熬那个汤，那个是就是最好的啊，的做法。OK， 来，还有什么问题？
请问一下，那个chef 他的那个鸡爪、鸡脚，
对，
如果我们熬太久，它的那 gelatin 会溶掉。
它会从那个鸡爪那边露出来，露到你的汤里面去。那么你如果熬超过六个小时的话呢，它的这个胶质就全部在那个汤里面了。那么你如果那个水蒸发掉的话，你再继续熬下去呢，那个汤呢就可能会有一点天然的稠度啊的稠度，对，叫做丁。那么你放在雪冰箱的时候呢，它会冻化上来了，它就会变成好像一个啫喱酱。明芳，你的问题，冷水下，对。你如果第一次沸水的话，从冷水下那个骨头煮到滚，去掉那个水，那么再冲洗一下，才用那个骨头来熬汤。对，用冷水，沸水的时候是用冷水。对。OK， 还有什么问题吗？你们可以在这边，我们还有点时间啊。Everybody is okay. Any more questions you want to ask?
You know the
oyster is not so good.
Sorry. Hang on. One by one. May you hold on first. I take Cheryl's question. Cheryl, come on first.
Yes, thank you. The fish stall soup, some of them have very murky, you know, unclear soup.
Yes.
Is it because they use the bones to boil for very long?
Okay, this one is not really about the bone, it's the control of fire. As I mentioned before, just now I was speaking in Mandarin. If you want a clear broth, a clear stock, right, when you add your bones into the water to simmer, the fire must be at its lowest, where it's a very gentle simmer. When you have a vigorous fire that's boiling up your stocks, right, you will end up with a very murky, creamy, kind of a soup color. That means the broth is not clear. It's very cloudy or it's very murky because the fire is the fire control is not good. If you are looking for a clear stock, you must use the gentle fire to simmer the broth. So if you are doing it in a vigorous boil, eventually after about 2 hours, you will see that your soup become very cloudy, become very white, creamy, that kind of thing. So that's what Japanese chefs would do for their tonkatsu ramen broth. They purposely put it on a high boil. Yeah.
Oh, so for that, is it for the purpose of extracting the bone
flavor?
Flavor?
Yeah. Okay. There's two schools of thought to this. Actually, whether you do the clear broth is what we call slow extraction. It takes a longer time to draw out the flavor, but it keeps the broth clear. The vigorous boil it draws out the flavor as well. It takes a shorter time, but then you don't end up with a clear stock. So it really depends on what is your final objective. Do you want a clear broth or do you want a rich, milky, cloudy stock, you know, in a shorter time? So that will depend on your fire control and what's your final objective. So like when we do Chinese double boil Chinese soups, right, we always steam or cook it in a slow cooker or in a very low gentle fire. Then when we want to do ramen broth, right, then we go for the vigorous boil.
Thank you for explaining. I always thought
it's a fire control soup.
Yeah, they added milk to make it murky.
That is the shortcut one. That is the shortcut, the what we call the cheater's way lah. Yeah, because traditionally, if you all have experienced the real yu tao mai fan last time in Hong Kong Street. What the hawker used to do is that they buy the fish bones from the market and then they cook the fish bones to that creamy, rich, collagen-rich stock. But nowadays, nobody do that anymore. So everybody...
Yeah, nowadays, it's murky, but the taste is not there.
Oh, it's all the evaporated milk taste.
Right. Thank you very much.
Okay, May, come. Okay, I can take your question now, May.
Sorry, because it's not a bit... I didn't really catch your full on the oyster sauce. But it seems that you say every dish we add, because you say add too much consumption of oyster... it's per se, it's not so good for the health. So if every time we add oyster sauce, no doubt we say it's a form of seasoning, it's more salt than anything. Is it still healthy in the long run?
Okay. My answer to your thing is actually it really boils down to the amount that you use. Now, if you say oyster sauce is salty, it's in the same level of I explained this to you all, everyone here from what we call the manufacturing point angle. The amount of salt in fish, in oyster sauce and soy sauce is very similar. Okay, it's not, the percentage level is quite similar. Fish sauce would be much higher, a bit more salty. And then of course, there's natural salt as it is also in as it is. So if you ask me, eating too much oyster sauce, is it bad for health? It really depends on the amount and the frequency that you are using, because it can be a yes, it can be a no. Of course, not everything we cook must add oyster sauce, because there are also other options, other seasoning options available. At the end of the day, okay, I say, if you have oyster sauce as one of your seasoning ingredient, try to keep it to that as a minimum. Okay, do not go and add any more fish sauce or soy sauce, because all this will contribute to the salt levels of the whole entire dish. That's why in my recipes, in the shows, right, you all watch every Saturday, right, you notice I use very little seasoning, different types of seasoning. Usually, I only focus on one or two maximum seasoning ingredients, and that's about it. So other things like sesame, all these are not really considered seasoning, because these are more like flavor top notes. Yeah, so mainly when we talk about seasoning, it's basically anything that contains a salt inside there. So it can be all these things that we just mentioned, chicken seasoning powders, fish sauce, oyster sauce, soya sauce, and et cetera. Even all the bean paste, you know, the fu yi, nam yi, all these also got salt one. Dou ban jiang, dao jiao, these are all also have natural salt in them. So when we use them, we try to avoid adding other extra seasonings because it will make the food too salty.
In other words, the oyster sauce don't contain a lot of oyster. It's only
about 0.5 to 1% of the whole entire bottle. That is what the industry standards is.
Yeah. Okay, thank
yeah,
you.
Yeah, so I hope that in the Chinese New Year series, I can probably I'll try to see if I can teach you how to make your own homemade oyster sauce.
Oh, that's good.
It's a lot more flavorful, but then, 我要先讲啊，这个家里自己酿出来的蚝油啊， 是不能收太久的哦。 所以你们要吃的时候才做， 因为这个蚝油啊， 我们在家里酿做的蚝油啊， 不是像工厂那么样的， 那种高科技的造法， 我们这个是在家里自己熬， 自己吃的， 自己吃自己用就可以， 不过是不要做很多的那个分量， 因为这个是， 不会符合那个卫生的那个什么的，我们在家里自己。请问一下，听说那个如果我们的鸡season，这个
oyster sauce 不可以煮太久，是真的吗？不是，这个没有这个道理的，因为它讲 oyster sauce 不可以煮久，没有。
其实蚝油没有，你有些菜呢，你需要用蚝油来焖的嘛，因为如果没有用那个蚝油来焖的话，你煮不出那个味道。OK，等一下啊，我看一下那个 chat bar 里面那些问题。 OK，Wifeng，you have 把烹饪小厨教导的和。OK， 哦，烹饪小厨啊，等一下啊，我看一下那个 chat bar 的问题先，有。 其实我自己本身有出过几本烹饪书了，以前在大众书局有跟他们一起合作过，那么现在你讲外面我的潮州美食烹饪书有，其实我有两本，在2015年出版的，不过是英文版啊，so it's all written in English. My Teochew cookbooks are out in Kinokuniya and some popular bookshops. You can see my face there. One of them is Teochew Heritage Cooking. And the other one is called the Little Teochew Cookbook. 那个我给你们看，你等一下啊。可能这边不懂有没有，我再找一个。OK， 这一本呢就是小本的，这个就是我写的那个，这个是潮州小吃跟那些季节的小吃。 So this one is all on festive. Festive and street food. Yeah, so these are all the what we call the small kuih recipes, chui kuih street food that we eat, that has got Teochew elements in it. Then I show you my the other cookbook, which you all can find all this in Kinokuniya and popular bookshop. 这个是大本的，这个就是大点菜. Yeah, this one is the bigger, this one is all the restaurant and home style cooking dishes. Yeah, so this is what I publish. Both books are available in Kinokuniya and in popular bookshops, and you can also order online from Amazon. Also, they also have. Okay. Yeah. Okay. 等一下啊，看到一个，请问酸辣汤可以用柠檬水吗？ Lina, your question on using lemon to replace. 其实哦，酸辣汤如果你叫我说做用柠檬，其实不是说不可以，可是因为黑醋。 Okay, black vinegar has its own special taste and fragrance that cannot be replaced by the lemon. 因为柠檬是柠檬的味道. Okay, 同样的两个都是酸的材料，都是有酸味的材料。可是呢，柠檬是柠檬的味道，醋是醋的香味。So, 这个就是看你个人的喜欢。因为有些人不喜欢那个黑醋的那个镇酱醋的那个味道，所以他们自己用柠檬来代替。 其实是可以的，没有对跟错，是你个人的喜欢。因为我了解有些人不喜欢那个黑醋的味道，所以你可以用柠檬来代替，这个是没有问题的。
谢谢。
OK, any other thing you all want to ask?
我问你刚才你说那个鸡骨熬两个小时那么那个水就会越来越少所以开始的时候我们是不是可以放很多很多的水给它去慢慢熬可以通常你有听过人家讲吗三碗煮成一碗啊好像熬鸭菜这样有时候我会用
slow cooker 去放它 overnight 去熬
slow cooker 就
overnight 去煮这样的话会太长的时间吗
不会，其实不会。如果你是想要熬隔夜的话，你的那个火候你不要调的太高。通常你是用 slow cooker 的话，只是给它这样温温的煮。那么你这样温温的煮的话，那个水也不会很快的蒸发掉嘛，所以你可以煮熬隔夜这样慢慢煮都可以的。嗯，请问
chef
没有关系的，不会说影响到它的营养失去营养上。
不会，这个是不会的。好，谢谢。OK 的，来 ，Carol 有问题？Yes。What
about using the magic pot 呢？Just throw everything in and then just overnight let it sit.
Can magic pot also works like a slow cooker, so you can do that also no problem.
The good thing is it doesn't the water doesn't evaporate so.
Yes, correct. It's all about temperature control. So like I say, if you put it on a, yes. So let's say that for example, if you are doing a 2 liters. I mean, you want 2 liters of good broth. Usually, I start with what 5 liters of water, and then let it slowly simmer down. Yeah. So y'all can when y'all need to know how much stock you want to get right at the end of the simmering. Then from there, we always add double the amount, and then we simmer it down. Yeah.
One, your own personal experience.
Okay, so.
想问你哦，那个 thermal cooker 反而不能够煮长时间，反而不能够出味，对不对？thermal
cooker
哈，它反而是肉更烂，可是它的汤的味道还不会出。其实应该是会的，因为如果你把那个肉煮到烂的话，那个汤的味道已经在那边。对我来讲呢，是你的调味放的不够。哦，OK，好，谢谢。盐放的不够，盐或者是那个调味料，鸡精粉还是那个。 塑料的那个调味料，那个香菇粉你放的不够，就没有那个味道出来了。其实我们吃东西啊，我们讲的方言所说的"别加薄逼"啊。其实哦，如果你有用那个心思去煮的话呢，如果你觉得那个食物是没有味道啊，很淡的话呢，就是你的调味下的不够，你可以少许多点那个调味料，那么你再试那个味道，边煮边试会比较好。可是你每次你试的时候呢？ 先喝一口白开水，清洗一下你的味觉，那么才试那个味道，因为如果你一直这样试下去的话，你的盐的那个成分在你的舌头还留在那边，所以你就会，你的调味就不是很准确了。
我想请问一下哦，如果一锅汤煮了，它的水分越来越少，那么我们可以加热水下去。
补充那个水分来煮吗？可以，开水用开水，煮滚的开水。它的味道会减低啊。就是看你要加的分量多少。如果你补充少许的话，这样半杯到一杯，那你再试一下那个味道。如果是淡化的话，就加点盐下去咯。我们通常都在厨房都是这样自己调味。 所谓的抓那个味道就是这个道理。我们因为水是会被蒸发掉的，在煮的过程是会被蒸发掉的嘛。所以你蒸发掉存在那个锅里面就是那个盐。那么我们再加水的话，那个盐呢又变成淡化了。所以淡化了之后，你吃那个味道如果没有那个味道的话，你就加一点少许的这个盐下去补充一下咯。嗯，谢谢。OK，Y Phone，你的question，气压锅。 气压锅其实熬汤不是很好，因为它是高温度。 OK， 第一，气压锅煮出来的汤呢，通常是不会清的，因为它是高气压高温度，它的汤通常煮出来的呢都是那种奶白色，也不会很清甜。那第二，它的不够时间取出那个味道，所以如果你 要用气压锅来煮汤的话呢，其实我对我来讲不是一个很好的做法。对，气压锅你如果是要煮那个把那个肉给煮烂的话，那个就很好用。对 把如果是要所谓的熬那个汤的话呢，不是一个很好 的器材。
What sort of equipment is that?
Pressure cooker.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because pressure cooker, given the high pressure, high temperature, right, your soup will not be clear. The soup will be cloudy. Yeah. And then also the short cooking time doesn't really draw out so much flavor extraction. So when we go to the long process, right, 3 hours, 4 hours, right, there is more time for the heat to draw out the flavors from the bones, from the spices, from the other ingredients. 尤其你是在熬补汤的话，更不可以用气压锅，因为你在熬那种补汤。If you're doing those kind of nourishing soups, you want the goodness from the herbs and all the ingredients that you are adding in. So you need to give it time for the nutrients to come out. So if you're using a pressure cooker, it's too fast, too furious already. There's no time for the nutrients to leach out to the soup for you to enjoy the benefits. Yeah.Okay, so 大家都 okay 了吗? I think seems like today we have a very nice long session for question and answer.
谢谢。
Okay, then 如果没有问题的话 then 祝你们周末愉快 have a good weekend. 我们下个星期六再见。Yeah.
好，谢谢。
Yeah,
谢谢老师，谢谢。
Have a good weekend.
谢谢，拜拜。谢谢师傅。
Over to you, Gary.
所以下个月九月的我们会限定五个乐龄从拉丁马士的五位乐龄来到我们的厨房，然后就是看那个厨师示范他的道菜。我需要限定到五个人，所以全部五个人可以有机会试试一点的那个的那食物。所以有兴趣要报名的话，请让我知道了。
Okay, 没有问题。Okay, so everybody remember, sign up early here.
这个星期什么菜呢？
不要跟你们讲，先卖个关子。Okay, 谢谢大家，周末愉快。See you next week.
谢谢。
Bye-bye.
谢谢，拜拜。
Okay, Gary, anything now before I log off?
I think you can go already. Thank you so much.
Okay. No worries. Ciao, ciao. Bye-bye. See you all.